So historically, the programming world has been primarily male and primarily white, especially in the US. And so what we have to do intentionally is say, if we believe that that's not the way it should be, if it should be open and accessible to everybody, that means we have to do really intentional work to make this change. The good news is there are people in the Laravel community who are actively trying to make a change. And it goes from organizers like people like Taylor, also Ian Landsman, who runs a lot of the Laravel conferences, really going out of their way to try to find speakers who aren't just from the same traditional set of people we've also had. So there's also a lot of people who are doing this work from the ground up. Zuzana Kunckova from Larabelles is a fantastic example because she found herself a woman in a primarily male space and said, you know what, I bet I'm not the only one, right? I want to find other people I can connect with. And so she made an intentional space for women and non-binary and trans developers to be able to be celebrated, to be supported, and to have a network of connections.
I was looking for a community. So I like the Twitter community, but because I was a woman, and I was quite older. I felt older than the other people, potentially. So I wasn't like, even me getting into tech, I started quite late. I wasn't one of those people that started as a teenager, or, you know, young people getting, you know, learning how to code. No, I started to code when I was 35 or 36 even. So I was kind of looking for something, you know, I would have something in common with other people. I wanted to read the stories of people who started learning this framework and maybe they were in the same situation like I was, like having small children, changing career later in life. But I couldn't find anything. So I couldn't find any Laravel ladies or, you know, nothing like that. So I actually asked on Twitter once if there is some community for women Laravel developers that I haven't found yet. And I was told that no, there isn't one, and why don't I create one? But that was back when I was really, I mean, I knew Laravel for about 3 months at that point, and I wouldn't consider myself a Laravel developer at that point at all. So I was like, who am I to make a community? I mean, you know, I know nothing. But so I didn't. But it was always at the back of my mind, and it stayed there for about 2 years, that I kept like, I was expecting somebody else to make one. Like, I was genuinely expecting somebody to come up with the idea and say, okay, I've created a community for women or for parents or something, and I would just join and everything would be great. But nobody did that. So for 2 years, it was kind of brewing at the back of my mind. And I ran it by my friends and they all said, make it, make one, do it. I was like, well, I'm hardly a Laravel developer. Who am I to make a community? Like, I don't know, I've never made a community before. I don't know what it means. What do I do? And they just said, like, just start on Twitter, see who's, you know, what people say, make a simple website and take it from there. So this is what I did. Like, after 2 years of like thinking about it, but doing nothing about it, then I made a website in a day and Twitter account, and then I just went public. And I remember that day, I was just thinking, because I had like 300 followers on Twitter, like hardly anyone knew me. I was like, if somebody just likes the post, that would be great. Maybe somebody replies, that would be like, great success. But on that day, what happened is that it just went crazy. Like, it was the perfect Twitter storm. And I remember just sitting at home and thinking, oh no, what have I done? Like, I did not expect, honestly, I thought if I have a few people comment, that would be great. But at the end of the day, it was, yeah, that day was crazy. The conversation that started because of me announcing Laravel, it was so eye-opening. So we had lots of people that supported us and encouraged us, but there were also people who were questioning, why do we need a community for women? Why do you need a, like, what's the point? Why are you breaking up a perfectly good community? So there were people who wondered, why would I be doing it? And they didn't see the benefit in it. They saw more of it like a disadvantage. Like, you are separating a group of people, and, you know, instead of uniting community, you are breaking it up. So that was eye-opening for me because, well, I saw the benefit because I was really building Laravel for myself, first of all. But it was interesting to see or read what other people had to say about it, why they thought it wasn't needed. And because of this conversation, it kind of helped me to focus my attention on certain things. So some people would say, oh, we never, you know, our company is employing women, they never had any problems, or they could get jobs. Like, what are you talking about? But it was interesting to see that this was somebody's experience, but then other people would say, yeah, but I am a woman and I find it hard to find a job. And even if I do find a job, and then I'm the only woman in a company of 20 men and it's not always comfortable. So I think the first milestone was to that first day, that huge, you know, conversation that I read all the replies and kind of took notes of what I would like to address eventually. And then I went on to start the newsletter.
I think what Zuzana's doing with the Larabelles community is a really, really good thing. I think it's definitely made me aware of that there's more women in the community than I knew about. And I think it's encouraged a lot of women to join. I do remember when she started the community, there were some members in the wider Laravel community that, you know, said, oh, we don't need this. Like, why do you need a women-only group in there? And I think they were kind of missing the point of what that helped bring. Like, ultimately, no community would need, you know, a special kind of minority mini group within the main group. Like, it's kind of, you know, it'd be nice if we didn't have to have that. But having those things is how we get enough women to where we don't actually need those communities anymore. Do you know what I mean? I think like Larabelles and everything Zuzana is doing is fantastic. And I really just hope to see it, you know, keep growing and growing.
So to have a community for me or about people like me, I think the reason I found it important was there is a lot of, so there aren't that many women developers, or if there are, they are not very public, not on Twitter, so I couldn't find any. I think when I was looking, I found two. So I found Samantha Guides that I mentioned earlier, and I found Jess Archer. So these were two women Laravel developers that I found. And I was actively looking for, you know, somebody else. And I couldn't find anyone. So I thought it's either that there aren't that many or they are there, but I, you know, they're hiding, they're not very public. And I didn't want to be the minority. You know, I wanted to have more people. I wanted to share my story with others. I wanted to read other people's stories. I wanted to know it's possible to be a woman in tech, because back then it didn't feel that possible. Not because anyone would be stopping me, but because I just didn't see women there. So I thought, if there aren't that many women developers, why not? What is the problem? Does it mean that it's not for us? Or does it mean it's like companies don't hire women developers? What is it? I am, first of all, I'm looking for people who work with Laravel, and then I want to give them the community so we can chat to each other, and if you need help, and if you maybe don't want to ask publicly, there are people you can ask privately, so support. The next step will be to have mentors or to be mentors. So if you are a Laravel and you want to mentor somebody else, somebody who's maybe just beginning, I want that to be the opportunity for each other, so that we will help each other. But I think if we want to make a difference, we want to bring more people into Laravel. So the next thing I'm going to be focusing on is maybe bringing more people, maybe even new developers into Laravel.
Laravel's movement is important because, of course, you can say, yeah, if you have to want to be equal to everyone else, why have this Laravel thing that is not for everyone? But I think it's still hard if you're a woman or non-binary or trans to get into tech as same as a white guy, let's say. So maybe you say, okay, I'm a woman and I will have a hard time at a company. And then you get empowered by all the other people that made it in Larabelles. And the second one about Larabelles is we are visible. Like, hello, we are trans and women people and non-binary people, and we are there, we exist. And we do tech or developing like everybody else. And there is no difference if I am a woman or not. I can do the same thing. I can be like really good at what I do, and I can be competent. And I think as soon as we have like full equality for everyone, you won't need anything like Larabelles anymore. But I think we have a long way to go until then.
To be fair, I was a little bit worried at the beginning that I wouldn't find that many people. You know, especially when we got quite public, people started talking about us, and I would get emails like from companies saying, oh, what can we do? I was like, I hope I can prove to you that there is more of us. But back in my mind, there was this little voice saying, what if there aren't? What am I going to do if I can only find like 5 women and that's it? What's going to happen? But luckily, and I'm so grateful that I have been able to find all these women. So 20 so far, and I've got more lined up. That to me is a huge success. And I think just them asking these questions, this is a great step forward. So that's a huge milestone to me that I think kind of, I don't want to say that I did it, but I think by me creating Larabelles, it's inspired people to have these conversations among themselves, to maybe look around their company and say, okay, why don't we have that many women here? Like, what's happened? What can we do differently to maybe encourage more women to apply? Because having more, not just women, but having more diverse company, it's better for the company, it's better for the product. So that will benefit everyone. So for me, that conversation and these companies and individuals approaching me, for me, that's again another huge milestone, because that means that people are now talking about it. And I believe once we start talking about it, it can only improve. And one thing that I've noticed, which was really great to see, is that the latest Laracon Online, which happened in September, there were 6 women speakers, and that was the most women speakers there were in any Laracon. And Laracon has been going on for I don't know how many years. So that was, I mean, again, I don't want to say that it's thanks to Larabelles, but I think at least to partly it might be, because now women have a place to talk, they have a place that they can come to for support.
I think it's always been a passion of mine for Laravel to be open to anyone, because Laravel started as a project that was maybe not the norm. So I think I always have a soft spot for diversity and including people that may not be traditionally included in programming ecosystems, because I feel like that's really at the beginning of Laravel. So things like Larabelles initiative to get women more involved in the Laravel ecosystem, to get minorities more involved in the Laravel ecosystem, is always going to have a special place in my heart, because Laravel has always been for everybody, and it's been especially for people who may not fit in, like in the traditional programming ecosystems. Like, that just always is going to resonate with me, because it goes back to the very beginning of Laravel sort of being something that doesn't fit in, you know, the traditional story of what a framework is supposed to look like in PHP.
Laravel embraces diversity simply by encouraging people being nice to each other. And I think that's at the beginning of everything. You have to, people need to be kind to each other and respect each other. I'm a woman and I was changing career later in life, so I was a parent as well. I had other responsibilities. I am a Muslim, I am a covered Muslim. So all these things invite comments from people. And the fact that I felt comfortable talking to people on Twitter within the Laravel community, I think it speaks a lot about what the people are like, because they never made me feel any less for anything. Like, nobody ever commented anything about my hijab, nobody said anything about my religion. People are just kind to each other. And I think this is very important. If we want to invite more people, or if we want the Laravel community to be diverse, this is exactly what we need to do. We need to make people feel comfortable. It doesn't matter who you are, it doesn't matter what you like. We are all here, we work with the same framework, and we are going to respect each other and be kind to each other, and that's it, there is no other way. And I think because of the community being like this and people there actively, you know, making sure that it is like this, this is what makes the community so diverse and welcoming diversity as well.